And we are back. It's Freestyle Friday here on the MLD Network. And there is some business for me to attend to. 100 subs have finally registered within this channel. And that means you guys get to meme the ever-loving crap out of me. But I'm going to make you wait till the end of the stream. However, this is a liter of Brisk. It is all going to attempt to be drank in one go while dabbing. You guys know what you're looking forward to. Alongside me today is Chimblade. Chim, I know you're looking forward to this, but only because you get to be a spectator as I make an absolute mockery of myself.
Yes. Yes. I mean, I think it's pretty genius what you've done. You've given people an incentive to stay till the end. But there is a loophole. You could just not watch the entire stream and come back at the end. But where's the fun in that, right? So hopefully most people actually watch it all the way through and then get the amazing outro to what should be an amazing Friday night, Freestyle Friday, as you guys like to call it. Up first is the Jets and the Pandas in the Plat League. Is there any, are there any fun facts or anything you want to bring up about these two teams in particular, Jay?
The Pandas right now still struggling really, really hard to find their feet on the season here. They're no stranger to slow starts, but this season seeming more than anything is probably one of their worst in a while right now, just grabbing the standings at the moment. They sit 5-15 right now, not bottom of the league, but very much one of the most struggling teams in the Orange Conference right now. And it's going to take a lot of work for them to turn it around, especially now that we're at the halfway point of the season. This is week 5. It's a 10-week season for Platinum League. So they need to start putting some wins up on the board starting right now.
Hopefully they can do it now. We have both teams in here, so they can go ahead and jump in. And we'll see if the Pandas can better that 5-15. Standing, because like you mentioned, it's not that great, and as we approach the second half, you want to start ramping up. Hopefully they can hit net positive in their wins versus losses, but they're in now. The Jets, Cracer Link, and Key Beast up against Palm Wonderful and Prometheus on the Pandas. We've seen the Pandas, I think we and the Jets multiple times on stream so far this season. I see them come back and play more games on stream. There's kickoff number one, went out by Prometheus, it looks like. Chrysler, though, does race through. Play one out towards the corner, nobody's home. This should be a shot on net from Key Beast. He misses out Chrysler on the follow-up. That should go underneath the crossbar, and it does. The Jets open up the game.
The Pandas get caught up really badly here. Prometheus had the opportunity to clear that away as Kev Beast flew way up over top of that one. No contact there. Chrysler just having to wait, let that one fall. It's opening blood here for the Jets.
Just 11 seconds in as well. Good from them, although Kev Beast missed the initial shot. Nice to see that Chrysler Link was there to back up his teammate. There he is once again, looking to put one center. Will be cleared away though by Palm as he follows it up for a double touch in the air. Thankfully though, for Kev Beast, at least that one's nowhere near his net. He'll follow through now out from the corner. Finds a channel towards the center of the box, but Chrysler Link a couple seconds behind the play. Another center from his end and still the ball will be deflected and cleared away by the Pandas. This time it's Prometheus. Kev Beast picks up some boost, plays it out. Chrysler, very patient at the top of the box, finally goes up for it. Palm Wonderful, though, there first. And as we approach the 4-minute mark, the Jets looking to extend the lead, find that second goal. The Pandas, they seem just as passive as they've been for the opening minute so far. There's a shot on net. Palm, though, able to clear it away.
Yeah, the Pandas right now, they're really struggling with boost management, getting hemmed in their end as the Jets pressure mounted. Nobody going out to get any boost, even the small pads. Again, going to Prometheus' camera there, no boost in the tank as he came all the way back, didn't pick up any of the pads on the way back. That's really hard to defend when you don't have boost in the tank.
Oof, Kev trying his luck from afar, will miss out. Goes back towards it though, it's out high from the corner. Chrysler does have the boost to get there in time. It's not the best touch. Kev to follow through. A boomer, but it will go out towards the left wing, and this means Palm is in 1v1 against Kev Beast as they go back towards the ball, racing for possession. It's in front of the blue net now. There's a clear from Chrysler Link. Not the best one, though. The ceiling could get in the way of that clear finding much distance. There's Chrysler, though. Thankfully, his opponent missed out on the touch there, and now he's got possession. Palm, though, will pick it right back up. Full tank to work with as well here as Kev Beast contests, loses out, and Chrysler Link should be there in time. Yes, he is. Kev Beast looking for a quick inside cut, cannot get a touch on the ball, and that means that Prometheus now is back on the attack for the Pandas, and the Pandas still struggling. Not a single shot registered on net.
Not just no shots registered on net, they are struggling just to keep the ball in control and get it upfield. But as I say that, Palm Wonderful actually, with the Animus GP, great control off the missed touch by Kev Beast.
Yeah, we didn't see this for the opening 2 minutes of the game, so you were in the right when you said they're not doing this, and then suddenly they did it, so props to them for pulling it out. And we mentioned halftimes. We mentioned the halftime of the season so far in week five, and you want to start building up before you actually get to the end of that half, and they're doing the same thing here, just within a game. They're starting to build up the lead and get shots on it before they actually hit that halftime, so they can excel in the second half of this game one. And hopefully the second half of the league, there's a shot exactly at halftime. The Pandas find the lead for the first time in the series.
Chrysler Link unfortunately just gets that ball too far ahead of him in the corner, and Kev Beast just completely misses that challenge there. Bomb Wonderful, a little touch to get it behind him, but that really had to be Kev Beast to clear. Just took the wrong line, got a little bit around it with the side flip.
Yeah, Jets, they're now tied 1-for-1. I mean, 2-for-2, rather, in terms of shots on net with the Pandas. They've, however, only scored one of their two shots. There's Kev Beast now towards the left wing. He sees two players there. He could have opted to take it out towards the right side or the far side, and instead he tried to move forward, and with both the defensemen there, that was a difficult task, one he could not accomplish. There's Kev Beast once again, allowing Kracerlink to go up for this ball instead. Palm, though, clears it out wide, and Kev Beast should be there for the touch. Nice parry to the corner. Palm, though, keeping the ball up. Prometheus, a bit of an overcommit from his end, but he does get a bump that translates into two bumps in the end. Palm looking to finish it off. Kracer, though, back on top. There's Kev with a long shot towards the far post. Prometheus not there in time. Kracer to finish the post, though, keeping us at a 2-1. And the Jets still struggling to find that equalizing goal.
Right now, I feel like those two chances, they really could have slowed the play down just a touch and had a great opportunity. Now they're going to have a two-point swing the other way as Palm Wonderful takes a big save, though, by Kev Beast as he gets back just in time. You have to convert those opportunities when you're given them, though, Chim. And the Jets might be lamenting those as this game goes on.
Yeah, thankfully for them, though, that repeat of goal number one for the Pandas didn't repeat as a goal number three with Palm on the ball. And then Animus just dribbling it downfield. Thankfully, they ran away from that one. There's Prometheus, though. Second touch needed. Will not find it. Now Kev Beast from the right side. Looking to cut inside. It's a hard pass from the corner. Where's his teammate? Kracerlink waiting out back. They've still got a minute to go. No need to overextend too much, but they have to start worrying a bit. Pick up the pace as we move forward, especially if that goal three goes in. Thankfully, it won't just yet. Palm, though, ensures goal three does go in. And Palm picking up four shots to his name, three goals to his name, a hat trick. They're up 3-1.
Kracerlink unfortunately just rolled that one right into the wheelhouse for the Pandas to clear. Palm Wonderful, great lob shot. Put Kev Beast in net on an island there. Post, back out to Palm Wonderful. Easy touch in, and that's a two-goal lead, an important one.
Yeah, great time to secure that two-goal lead as well with only 48 seconds now left to play. There's Palm for the Pandas after having a very passive early game in game one, and they looked like they would struggle to even equalize for a 1-1. And since then, they've got them more comfortable on the attacking side. They've extended their lead to 3-1. Nice to see in this opening game of the set of five tonight. There's Kev Beast out towards the right side. That will go wide, but if he can follow up quickly and get there first, he might have a chance on net. He will miss out, but at least he did get there first. So it's nice to see the Jets also are improving at getting to the ball first. Just need to be a bit more accurate when they do get to the ball first and have a shot to take. 10 more seconds to go, though, and Pandas know if they just keep the ball here in this corner, they will secure a game one victory. Not much else to say for this game as Palm puts in goal four, because hey, why not? They're already winning 4-1 now for the Pandas. That should be the final scoreline of game one.
And this one, you really start to look back at the first half of the game, the first 2 minutes in particular, and then the amount of pressure the Jets got on the Pandas net and how nothing came of that. And once they weathered the storm, they came out, got that ball upfield, and really put the Jets back on their heels and staked themselves out to that lead. That's where that game changed.
Yeah, and I mean, we talked about it's good to see teams change before the halftime mark, and they did. I think it was like at 2:40, the Pandas said, let's stop being so passive. Let's start trying to match the number of shots the Jets are taking on our net. Let's try to find some possession on the blue side of the pitch, and they did, and it worked for four goals in a row. Well, really three goals in a row, that fourth one, everybody had given up. So like three goals in a row, they were just pounding shot after shot on net.
Yeah, the surprising thing, I think, was more that all of the Pandas' offense came from one player. It was Palm Wonderful, 4 goals on 5 shots. And once he let himself go, you could feel that once he kind of got a little bit more into the game and he started getting the ball in his possession, being a little bit more comfortable with it, the Pandas' play really changed because he just had that freedom to be able to go forward and really work that offense, even though it was a lot on the counterattack.
I mean, if you can capitalize on counterattacks consecutively or consistently, go for it. Why not? If the Jets are giving you those opportunities, which they are, and you see how good Palm is at controlling the ball with that Animus, and pushing it down the field. You saw him two times in a row dribble from end to end, scale the entire pitch. And out of those two times, one of them went to the back of the net. So if he can continue that style of play, if he can continue to be the goal scorer for this team, look, he's trying to do it again. Beats one defenseman, has to cut towards the far post, pops it up. Nice pop. And once again, it's Palm Wonderful. We'll finish it off. No, the save comes through from Kreiserlink, but still he takes it end to end and just can't finish.
Last season, Palm Wonderful, the dribbles cutting apart defenses throughout the league. This time he does it all the way onto the goal line. Just could not get enough velocity across the line before Kreiserlink could get back and pinch that one off the post. Really good defense from the Jets.
It's gotta hurt though, because it seemed like Palm had the chance, and then he hit the post and he had to spend a couple of seconds sort of getting back for the rebound, and that couple of seconds allowed the defenseman to come in. And that was Kreiserlink who got the save at the goal line there. So props to him as well. There he is now, up higher for the Jets. Looking to strike first blood here. Game two, like they did in game one. And in game one, it took them only 11 seconds for them to find that opening goal. They haven't found one, though, in the past minute and 20. There's Palm out past the center line. Will follow through as well. Kreiserlink, though, beats both the defensemen. Doesn't have the boost to get back in time. And that's a free pass to Kreiser, who gets demoed. Kev looking to follow up. Will be a slow ball, and that should be an easy enough clear from Palm Wonderful, which it is. 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go. The Pandas and the Jets still struggling to find anything in the back of either net. Kreiser, though, should have the shot. Far post will go in. 1-0 for the Jets.
A little bit of a misplay here from the Pandas. Prometheus very stacked up right underneath his teammate Palm Wonderful. As Palm loses a challenge in midfield, Prometheus just has no time to react. And Kreiserlink falls on that loose ball to get the lead for the Jets. They scored first last game, but they didn't manage to hold it, Shim. We'll see if they can do that here in game two.
Yeah, the biggest difference was that Palm Wonderful in the opening half of game two. He was very quiet. He was sitting at zero shots, and then he started to sort of break out, get comfortable. And that's when the Jets were taken by surprise. They didn't know how to respond. But now that they have seen how Palm performs when he, you know, starts feeling comfortable, which it seems like he has been, for game two, he's put two shots on net. Now that they know that Palm is going to be the man they have to focus on shutting down, they can hold on to the lead, hopefully even extend it here in game number two. There's Palm once again. Good control on the Animus. Pops it up towards the crossbar. Needs a rebound. Instead centers it up for Prometheus, who's not there in time. And Kev now looking to break away. That's a difficult angle. Trying to hunt it down, but in the end, the ball will escape him. And as we approach halftime, the Jets are still sitting with that one goal advantage, and the Pandas finally are breaking away now. There's Prometheus. He misses out. Kreiserlink with a full tank. He's got Prometheus to beat here. A quick shot. If he can split the defenseman, it could work out. Out towards the crossbar. Kev coming in. Palm Wonderful, though. The man with the great control on the ball. Able to clear this one away. Full tank as well. One more shot, and he can do it. Dribbles it past two defensemen, and the Pandas back on top thanks to Palm Wonderful.
Really good control on this ball here. Grabs a boost, just a little touch to get in front of him, pull in the defender, then goes right around that little touch to the left to pull that one outside of the direct line that the Jets defense was taking at that one. Tie game again through another Palm Wonderful goal.
I mean, what's the answer to Palm Wonderful for the Jets? Because if it's only Palm Wonderful that's actually scoring and mostly off of, you know, end-to-end dribble plays, how do the Jets shut that down?
Either demo him to take him out of the play or force him into situations where Prometheus is going to make a mistake that he can't cover. So getting a better challenge on the dribble or simply getting the ball out of the reach of Palm Wonderful.
All right, we'll see if they can do that then. Demoing might be, in my opinion at least, is the better option of the two. Much easier to one to execute. There's Kreiserlink popping one up high. Will not go for the second touch though. Decides against it. Rotates back out. Buys himself some time and picks up some boost during that time. There's his teammate Kev Beast now. It's a very high ball. Kreiser tries for it, but decides once again against it and instead plays it out towards the wall. Looks to follow through. Palm, though, picks it up. He's got Prometheus waiting, shadowing the play. Actually, out towards the center now. There's a long pinch clear from Kev Beast. Will go in front of the green net. Palm Wonderful needs to save quickly. Thankfully, he will find it. 1:05 to go. There's Kreiserlink up high to Kev. Good idea. And the crossbar will keep us at a tie 1-1 game.
Yeah, big save though by Prometheus. I was going to say on that first clear by the Jets, it was a really good way to try and get Palm Wonderful out of the play. Had him on the dribble, got him in real close, won the challenge, and Prometheus was right back behind him there, beat by the same challenge. If Prometheus keeps on the double commits like that, and the Jets get big clears, they'll have the opportunities. They just need to make sure they convert.
35 more seconds, the next goal surely wins it. That's a risky double commit there, even though it didn't initially hurt them. If they repeat that in the remaining 30 seconds, they could be hurt, and they just did it there for a little bit. It's out towards the green, an empty green net now for Kreiser. Link, if he can get on top of it, Palm, though, will find the clear. 18 more seconds to go. There's Palm out towards the right side. Follows up and is able to pick away some midfield boost. That is looking not good at all for the boys in green. It will go off the woodwork, though. Kreiser Link misses out. Prometheus is there, but Kev Beast is ready as well as he'll play out towards the corner. Follows it up now from the wall. Final second. The ball, however, will hit the ground, and that's overtime. 1-1 for the Jets and Pandas.
Not a lot of chances in this game. Overtime, probably a fair result to decide this one, and I think it's really going to come down to which team blinks first on defense. The team that gives up possession a little bit too easily into a 2-on-1 or even a 2-on-0 probably going to end up losing this game with the way it's been going. I'm wrong! I'll just say that right now. I'm wrong! As Palm Wonderful gets a great intercept here. Little bit of a flick shot as both Jets get caught in the wrong spot there. Kev waiting, Kreiser Link retreating, and it just goes right up over top of them in the upper corner.
Yeah, and the stat holds for the Pandas. Both games, they've won both, and the only person to score for the Pandas has been Palm Wonderful. In game one, he scored 4 goals. In game two, he scored 2 goals. So, once again, shut down Palm. And there are different options to go through that. You saw them right there. Give up a free ball, and it was to Palm. So Palm is putting himself in the positions that are required to be able to get those free balls and score off them. He knows that Prometheus can just play support for the game.
Yeah, really, I think that the Jets just have to take advantage of the times where they beat Palm Wonderful on the challenge. They haven't been happening right a lot, but when they do, Prometheus is almost always in a spot where he simply can't defend effectively. The Jets just are not converting on their chances that they have right in front of that green net. They saw it in game one when they had all that pressure. We saw it again in game two where they had just a couple opportunities and did not make them count. Really need to improve that here in game three to get back in the set.
Yeah, both games the Jets have come out with the opening goal, and they, once again, just have not been able to hold on. They struggled a lot in game one. They did a bit better in game two, but still they couldn't ever get more than one goal. For two games in a row now, they've found their first goal and sort of just stopped. And it's all pretty much been to Palm Wonderful finding possession and pushing forward. This is Kreiser Link once again for the opening shot of the game. Out towards Kev Beast. It will hit the crossbar yet another time. This is Kreiser Link playing a pseudo third member of the team by cutting his rotation down short, and Palm on the Animus, looking to sneak towards the near post. Kev Beast, though, will shut that down for now. 4 minutes and 21 seconds to go. A repeat of games one and two. The Jets looking to find that opening goal. They're the ones putting the more pressure on for the opening minute. And again, they have to stick to it this time around.
And really, they had two great cracks at it right in front of the net to start that game off. Neither shot going in. They put them both high off the crossbar. You just get the sense that the nerves might have started to get the better of them here, and they're just not making their shots count again. Oh. Kreiser, like, right idea, doesn't get the execution. Just a little bit too high on the shot. Bar down, out. Still stay scoreless.
There we go. Finally, the Jets are able to put one in, but three shots off the crossbar. You said nerves, and I might have to agree with you. Maybe they've seen how the Pandas are that good at just coming back after being down 1-0 in both games. Maybe they're getting nervous in front of the Pandas.
Yeah, it's possible. They really have to convert those chances, though, and they do so really well on this one. Both Pandas get stuck trying to decide who's going to go for it, and Kreiserling just putting that one in over top of them both.
Kev and Kreiser pushing out towards the corner. Kev is all alone in the center, but finally the two defensemen have rotated back in their respective positions. There's a long clear out towards the corner. Kev with some boost. Palm will not win out that challenge, and Prometheus now will have to back away and instead chooses to go for the play instead, which means that now he's overextended to the blue side of the pitch. There's a shot on net from Kreiser Link. Palm, though, will be there to clear this one away. Kev not done with the pressure just yet. Kevin Kreiser both sitting around that midfield line, hoping to intercept the ball when it crosses into the blue side of the pitch, which it did, and they're able to clear the ball back towards the green. But now it's Palm out high in front of his own goal, misses out. Prometheus has a free ball, but Kreiser Link sweeps through, saves it, finds a demo as well onto none other than Palm Wonderful. There's Kreiser Link looking for a cheeky play, and he does what Palm does best, dribbles it past two defensemen end to end of the pitch.
I thought the demo might have screwed them up just a little bit there. Palm Wonderful respawning right where he needed to make the save. Just didn't quite get the read in time as Kreiser Link gets around him with that little touch back to the inside away from the direction that Palm Wonderful was traveling in.
And even though it wasn't a demo on Palm Wonderful when he had possession or when he was even on the blue side of the pitch, it was still just enough to take Pandas a bit out of the rhythm. And Palm Wonderful, they've noticed he's the key player to this Pandas team. Demo him. It doesn't matter where or how. Just demo him at some time in the near future and then try to break away as Prometheus has a chance. The save needed from Quasar Link. We've seen him find multiple saves from the goal line and try to set up Kev for those counterattack plays. They tried there once again and they could not do much with it. But a reminder, this is also the first time the Jets have scored more than one goal a game. So it's looking like a new Jets in this game number three.
Exactly. The Jets offense finally getting at least a couple of points on the board here. Need to keep that up though, because we saw Palm Wonderful score four goals in that opening game to take the Pandas on his back and take the first couple games of the series. Now, just really need to see what the Jets have in them as they defend for the next 2 minutes.
I mean, if that's the option they want to take, just defend for the next 2 minutes, that is a possible option. We have seen the Pandas, however, start to accelerate in the remaining in the final half of both games so far. So if they're going to defend, maybe they have to put a lot of focus on demoing Palm Wonderful, taking him out of the play on the defensive side. There's a shot towards the green net. Kev Beast looking to extend the lead. Will be cleared away, though, by Prometheus. And there's Palm bombing. Went out towards the blue side of the pitch. And once again, Palm now, for seven goals in a row, has been the only scorer for Pandas.
Yeah, unfortunately, Prometheus didn't get some great contact to get that ball away. It's enough to get it up the boards. Palm Wonderful sweeping through, gets the shot off the side wall, really good angle. Kracerlink on the way back, just could not get back in time. That is the goal, first goal on the board for the Pandas now. Still need one tied up.
You know, see if they can do it. We saw the Pandas not be able to find that second one in regulation time at least. And Palm Wonderful, two chips, beats both the defensemen. And it's just a deja vu over and over again for the Jets defensive line.
Well, you see them both turn around and try to challenge. It's that exact moment that Palm Wonderful picks it up on the hood, gets it in the air, and flicks it over top of the both of them. That one comes down to just giving a player who loves to dribble too much time and space to make their play.
Yeah, you want to use the word one-trick pony, but you can't. This is a one-trick pony, but not in the negative sense at all. It's still working, and if he can continue that one trick to beat the defenseman, why not? If it works, you know, don't fix it, if it's not broken, and that's just going to be the name of the game for Palm Wonderful and his teammate Prometheus. Prometheus just sets up Palm Wonderful, gets Palm Wonderful into positions where he has the option to either shoot from afar, like we've seen him do, or to go for a couple of dribbles, which we've seen him do more often. And that seems to be how the Pandas want to play. Props to them for making it work so far, three games in a row, if they can win it here. There's Kevbeast putting one on net. Palm, though, will find the clear. Quasar Link back on net. The defenseman not positioned right for that shot. They don't even try for it. 3-2 for the Jets.
Yeah, this is the kind of pressure you want. Palm Wonderful forced into an awkward clear. Prometheus gets hesitant at the top of the box. Doesn't know if he should go or try and block the shot. And Quasar Link just puts it right between them. Jets back in the lead here as they have the third one on the board.
40 seconds to go for the Pandas to find the equalizing goal here in game number three. And if I was a betting man, I would bet that it's Palm Wonderful to find that equalizing goal if they do find it. There's Kev Beast out towards the corner. We'll hit the backboard as well. A goal four surely will be the end of this game three if the Jets can find it. There's Palm. Gets a nice chip out towards the left side. Follows up on it here as well. Don't know if that was a fake or a miss, but that threw Prometheus off. And that means Quasar Link has an empty net. There's goal four for the Pandas. One small mistake means the end of the game for the Pandas.
Realistically, though, Prometheus has no business being that close to Palm Wonderful on that kind of double touch. This is what I'm talking about, the Pandas spacing, and it's only a matter of time before it started to come back and burn them. You need to give your teammates space, especially in twos, where you're the only player to cover for your teammate if something goes wrong in the play that they're trying to set up.
Yeah, game three, however, did shape up to be a much nicer game overall. 10 shots apiece. For each team, or 10 shots for the Jets, seven shots for the Pandas, so a much more shot-based game. They were much more focused on finding shots on net, whereas the previous two games was very congested in the midfield, and in this game, they took a lot of chances, even from afar. We saw Palm Wonderful. His first goal of the game came from off the wall, close to the midfield, so they were okay with sort of breaking away from their usual comfortable positions and trying different things, which is nice to see as we head into Game 4 and Game 5.
Yeah, exactly. A little bit better to see Prometheus a bit more involved this game. Had the assists, one save and one shot, but still, to me, just doesn't feel like he's quite comfortable playing with Palm. And a lot of that is the spacing I've been touching on for the last three games right now.
Right.
Really showed in this game where the Jets could take advantage of that. If the Pandas can figure that out, probably be able to secure at least the third game, possibly the fourth, because the Jets, despite getting one game where they managed to make their chances count, still look like they're struggling a bit on offense.
knows if they can find it, and they have been struggling, but at least they've been improving slowly but surely in terms of shot count. In game 1, they put on 4 shots. Game 2, they put it up to 5, and then in game 3, they doubled that with 10 shots on net. So they're looking better and better as they progress, and we'll see if the Jets can find that reverse sweep. They went down 2 games in a row. They took game 3, game 4, and game 5. Hopefully, will be more intense and more interesting ones. 4:40 on the clock. It's a clean slate for the two teams. We'll see if the Jets continue their pattern of always scoring first, always hunting down first blood and finding it. There's Palm Wonderful getting demoed. We saw it happen in the last game. They're going to try to repeat that tactic here in game 4. There's the save from Quaserlink. Palm Wonderful is positioned out towards the half line. He'll push it out towards the corner. Needs a second touch, though, and he'll cut inside. It's in front of the net. Prometheus, though, will not be there in time. Again, we said you mentioned it, Jay, at the break. They don't look that comfortable playing with each other, and that might be, you know, a symptom of that. They're just not on the same page sometimes when Prometheus or when Palm centers it. There's Kev Beast, though, finding the opening goal once again for the Jets.
Really get the sense, though, that the miss by Palm was more of a shot than a pass across the net. He misses a shot near side, bounces across there. But then another little bit of a misplay there is Palm kind of cuts off Prometheus on the clear, puts them both in an awkward spot. The Jets take full advantage of that one to bury the first goal. They've scored first in every single game in this series so far.
And we saw them do this in the last game. For the first time ever in game number 3, the Jets were able to score more than one goal. They've done it here in game number 4. If this repeats, it could be another, you know, 4-2 victory for them.
Yeah, unfortunately, Prometheus just doesn't react in time to that lost faceoff. He gets dunked on the way through by the Jets. 2 goals inside 3 seconds. And that's a really tough one for the Pandas to dig themselves out of right now.
Ooh, so it might be 3 goals and it goes towards the far post. And the Jets, out of nowhere, have suddenly built the biggest lead we've seen all series.
Yeah, this one, just a loose ball there. Palm Wonderful and Prometheus both very much clustered around that center boost canister. Neither one of them challenging it, and Kraserling just goes from downtown straight in. 3-0.
Hopefully we don't see a fourth goal, because that would be terrible for the Pandas. It's very difficult to recuperate from something like 2 goals in a row, 3 goals in a row, let alone, you know, if the fourth one comes in, that'll be crazy. There's Kev Beast out towards the backboard. Both defensemen commit for that ball. Quaserlink is beaten, though. Now it's Prometheus looking to set up Palm Wonderful, his superstar striker, but it will not happen as he gets demoed. And Palm Wonderful now has to keep the ball on the blue side, wait for Prometheus to respawn before they can set up their next play on net. There's a pass center, looks to finish it off himself. And once again, you get the sense that Prometheus not always on the same page with his teammate.
Well, fortunately, just respawned. Didn't have enough time, really, to get upfield and try and get in on that play as Palm Wonderful went for the double touch off the backboard himself. Just really little things at the moment for the Pandas. They did well in the first 2 games, basically give the ball to Palm Wonderful and see what happens. Now that play isn't working as well, and they're just having a really hard time adjusting to the Jets, who have really kind of figured them out, and these little bumps, these little touches, really throwing them off.
Yeah, we've seen that happen a lot here. There's Kev Beast out towards Kraser. Nice passing pattern. You see these two, when they go for passes, even if they don't score, the striker is at least there. Sometimes even for the Pandas, the striker isn't there when the pass comes through. So it doesn't matter that neither of them are scoring off a lot of these centered balls. What matters is that for the Jets, that striker is in position, whereas for the Pandas, he's not. There's Kraser link out towards the far post. Will pop up high as Kraser steals away some boost. Now Palm chips it past one. The good old Palm flick, we've seen it happen multiple times this game, more than a dozen it seems like, and he has scored many, many times off that play. There's an idea, opportunity for goal number 4. Kraserlink will secure it, 4-0 for the Jets. Once again, an unseen lead so far in the series.
Yeah, Prometheus just diving into that ball on the side, doesn't get any contact, right next to his teammate as well. Palm Wonderful, both of them clustered there. The Jets just take one touch to go straight up, 4-0 here. It's tough, I think, Chim, for the Pandas to come back from this one. They might just have to regroup, try to take the series in Game 5.
Yeah, that'll definitely have to be the trick for them. And, I mean, the Jets, you got to compliment them, right, for having such a close Game 1, Game 2, then barely winning it out in Game 3, and now suddenly 4-0 in a Game number 4. Make that 5-0 as Jets puts this one in, and it's just unprecedented, and props to them for making this work, just demoralizing the Pandas every chance they get.
And little adjustments in the course of a series go a long way, especially when they start paying dividends early enough that you can still salvage the series like they did for the Jets. Game 3, where you started to see the fruits of those changes, and they've really come on here in Game 4, completely dominant through the first 3.5 minutes.
There's maybe goal number one here as Palm Wonderful tries his luck with yet another flick, and at least for the... Sometimes you're up against a team and you have no idea what the problem is. You don't know why that team is winning. But at least for the Jets, it was very obvious who the playmaker was for the Pandas. Why the Pandas were, you know, putting on shot after shot. One member, right? Palm Wonderful. Shut him down and you should have won the game. That's what they've done so far. Once again, yet another demo on Palm Wonderful. Not necessarily when he has the ball, but just demoing him is enough for them to take control of the pitch for 3 seconds, right? Until he respawns. And that 3 seconds is all the time they need to find possession, set themselves up for a chance on net. And it's worked, you know. They're 5-0, 10 shots on net. They won game four. It's in the bag.
Yeah, they're going to get one put back on them here as Palm takes the demo, does enough to get this ball out front. Saw Prometheus there waiting. That's the kind of spacing that you want to see. You want to see that striker in position waiting for that center there, especially when both defenders commit so heavily into the corner looking for that physical play. Need to keep more of that up. Need to be more involved as Prometheus if they want to take game five.
Yeah, Prometheus finding, I think that's actually his first goal the entire night so far, so at least he's, you know, reminded himself how to score. He's tasted what it feels like to be a goal scorer. There's a attempt from Prometheus, once again a dribble play, and even if Prometheus can dribble as well as Palm, which I don't know if he can, but even if he could, it's not the best plan to just give it to one player and then hope for the best. That's what they're doing, giving it to one player, hoping that he can beat two defensemen. And we mentioned it worked for the first two games, it didn't work in game three, and it's not working in game four, so... For the all-important Game 5, there needs to be a huge mindset shift for the Pandas. They can no longer give it to one player and hope for the best.
Well, especially because that one player right now is being taken out of the play pretty much every time he gets close to a Jets player. You need to have a little bit more depth in your play right now as... Actually, Prometheus will take a second one. It was looked like it was almost a pinch play here. It's actually Palm just running that into the Jets, and Prometheus coming across, getting a great snap on the bounce here. Perfect timing to hit that ball. Upper 90 off the post and in. Momentum building here late in game four. They're going to need that as they try to take the series with the fifth game.
Yeah, this is also a great time for Prometheus to wake up. Right? If you've been asleep, let's say for three games in a row, game four is the best time to wake up because you set yourself up to, you know, be in full force for that game number five, which is coming up, and it's an important game five. You win game five, you win the series.
Exactly. And you always like to see series like this, especially when you're playing sets of five that go down to the fifth game, that they mean something. Close series, always more exciting to watch. But at the same time, there's a great storyline here because the player that's starting to heat up late enough in the series is the one that, you know, you and I both kind of identified as the one that hasn't really...
Right.
Been as influential in the game as their teammate. And that's the kind of thing that you really like to see, because if all four players come to the pitch to play for this game five, know there's going to be fireworks happening.
Yeah, I mean, at least hopefully Prometheus can come out of this and say, I wasn't influential in games 1 through 3, but I was influential in the all-important game number 5, and therefore I was influential to the series, which is what you want to, you know, be able to say at the end of an important series in a close series like this one. So hopefully Prometheus can wake up, which it seems like he has, especially, you know, because he scored the only two goals Pandas found in game number 4, and they were great shots from him, especially that last one. Beautiful shot right off the bounce, so he's mechanically there. There's Palm Wonderful going back to game 1, game 2 tactics. This time nobody from the Jets bullies him, and he takes that gift.
Yeah, unfortunately, Kev Beast went back, missed boost. You see him power slide into the corner to try and recover. Just had nothing to do to react to that one, especially after Kraesterling got beat on the sideboards there. Good lead now for the Pandas. Momentum still in their favor. 3 unanswered across 2 games after they gave up 5.
You know, we said we needed a big change from the Pandas in this game number 5, a mindset shift as well as a playstyle shift, and this was the first time, the first game in the series where the Jets haven't scored first, so that's a shift in itself. Even though it may not seem like it's that much, just for the Jets recognizing we didn't score first for the first time ever, and there were two games where we did score first and still lost. What happens when we don't score first? That question is now in their minds, and Pandas should be able to use that to their advantage here, especially considering they get a 1-up for the opening minute, and they have a lead now for the remaining 4 minutes of the game. There's Palm Wonderful out towards the far post. Beats two players somehow, not sure how that ended up happening, but thankfully Kev Beast is back to the defensive line. Kracer misses out. Prometheus. That's 2-0 for the Pandas. A big change.
This is the involvement we were looking for all series long. Palm Wonderful, little backflip there, cheeky, but catches Kracerlink off guard. Prometheus waiting right where he needs to be, top of the box, attacks it quickly, gets that over the line. 2-0 now for the Pandas, their biggest lead outside of game one where they kind of ran away with it.
Yeah, game one they ended up finishing 4-1, but certainly their biggest lead, or any team's biggest lead that this early into the series, actually scratched that. I feel like last game, Jets may have been 2-0 at this point, but for the Pandas at least, this is the quickest they've gotten a 2-goal lead, and that's good to see in an all-important game 5. As Palm uses the wall to beat one defenseman, beats two, and if he can get the pass to Prometheus instead of trying to be greedy here, it could work out. He gets the pass, and Kracerlink last second races through, clears the ball away, follows up on it as well. There's a shot towards the net. Palm Wonderful misses out, and Kracerlink just plows through the defensive line, finds a goal 1 for the Jets.
Yeah, the double commit on offense there. You really could see it trying to come off there. Prometheus just missed out on that one. And Kracerlink going straight up field, bullies that one through. The Pandas in transition, just couldn't recover on that one. Game on here, lead cut to 1. Lots of time left on that clock.
Yeah, solid 3 minutes and 10 seconds. And we've seen 3 goals already. So that's great to know that within the remaining 3 minutes, we might have 4 or 5 more goals to come through from these two teams. There's Kev. Gonna put one on net. Palm Wonderful though clears away. Prometheus looks to follow up. It will go towards Kev as he drops one down. There's a shot slash clear slash I don't even know from Palm Wonderful. Just booting up the field just for the sake of booting it up. Seeing if he can maybe follow through on it. And in the end he couldn't. And there's Kev Beast out from his own wing. We'll pick up some boost. Play to the center circle. Kracerlink is not there. Kev Beast is though. And they're both committed to the green side of the pitch. A quick breakaway attempt for the Pandas. Could mean a 3-1. There's Palm Wonderful once again, baiting one side of the goal, going towards the near post. 3-1.
Really tough to defend with no boost. You saw Kracerlink dive in, looking like he wanted that demo, missed contact, and then just gets completely frozen when he runs out of boost. Palm Wonderful at liberty to go clean around him and in. 2-goal lead restored for the Pandas just past halftime.
You know, though, Palm Wonderful is still the main goal scorer, Prometheus is still providing support and sort of padding up the number of shots on net. He's put on 1 for his team, and that one shot on net has gone, and that's all this team needs to now be at a comfortable 2-0 lead. As I say that, Kracerlink puts it right back over to only a 1-goal margin between the two.
Really good touch here by Kracerlink. Wins that challenge against Prometheus. Has lots of time to find that angle inside the near post there. Nothing Palm Wonderful can do. Back to a 1-goal game here as these teams are trading him back and forth. First team to score 2 in a row might be the team to take it.
Yeah, that seems like a reasonable thing to say, and I'm going to have to back you up on that one. We'll see who can score 2 in a row first. And there's Kracerlink out towards the green box. His teammate, though, Kev Beast, opted out of following. He knows there's still 2 minutes left. No need to be risky just yet. There's Prometheus out towards the wall. Struggles, though, to follow up on it. He's finally back on all fours. There's Kracerlink, though. He'll look to hold on to some possession. Play it out as he picks up some boost, no doubt. And now maybe look to cut inside, beat Palm at his own game. Palm, though, good at defending dribbles just as he is attacking with them. There's Kev Beast out towards the top of the box. Kracer follows through. 1 more touch towards the net. He finds near post, and he'll get demoed, but he makes the goal count. The Jets score 2 in a row.
Yeah, unfortunately, Prometheus there gets caught out. A really awkward spot to react to that ball. Didn't have any boost to turn around and chase either. Kracerlink upfield, just cuts it inside the post. That's 2 in a row for the Jets. It's a tie game. Momentum shifting in their favor here in game 5.
Yeah, and Kracerlink sort of playing a Palm Wonderful for the Jets. The only 5 shots for his team and the only 3 goals. And speaking of the devil, Palm Wonderful with yet another dribble play for the Pandas.
Great kickoff win by Prometheus. Just wins it past Kracerlink. Kev Beast stuck on the goal line a little too long there. Didn't really react in time to Palm Wonderful going right around the outside there. Almost like a running back going around the outside of the line of scrimmage in football there. Just picks that one up, runs it downfield for the first down.
Kev Beast with a full tank. 1:15 to go. The Jets, they want to be able to score 2 more in a row. We saw them do it once. They went from 2-3 to 3-3. Now they're sitting at 4-3. But if they can, you know, take this to 5-4, that could be the game. Prometheus, though, looking for the 5-3 scoreline. Cannot secure it. As Kracerlink out from the corner. Misses out. Now it's Palm. Nice little pass to Prometheus. At least Prometheus was there. They don't get the shot off, but at least he was there. That is a significant improvement from especially the opening games of the series.
Oh, good shot!
Throw off the bounce! Well placed, well done. Ties it up for the Jets.
Really good read by Kev Beast here. The 50-51 high off to the boards there on the hop right as it comes up off of the ground. Kev Beast lifting it up, just a great chip. The defense caught completely flat. Nothing they could really do with that timing. 4-4, this game is on fire right now.
The next goal's got to win it, right, Jay?
I mean, we're getting into golden goal territory at Shim. Overtime guaranteed, but you feel like there's still one more here in regulation.
Yeah, I'm feeling that too. One more here in regulation. Let's see it happen. There's Kev Beast out towards the left corner. Palm will pick up some boost and tried to be a bit cheeky there with the clear. Try to fake the clear and get underneath the ball. Didn't work out. He's good at the dribbles, but don't want to risk it on your own defensive half. There's Kraserlink now. Nice pop up to himself. Needs to find the near post. We'll play it up high instead. Kev Beast hesitating, but finally pushing forward. A shot on net. Will not work out. 6 more seconds of regulation time to go. There's Kraserlink out towards the top bar. Kev can't finish it, and that just might mean overtime. It will. It's 4-4. The Pandas and the Jets tied up in an all-important Game 5.
And X-Goal wins. The Pandas really come into their own towards the end of this series here, right when they needed to, but the Jets really good in responding to everything they're doing right now. X-Goal wins. You really don't know which team's going to do it at this point.
Ooh, Kraser wants to say it's the Jets. He'll put one towards the crossbar, give the Pandas a bit of a scare. Thankfully, it was only a scare, though. Nothing real. This Palm wonderful out from the right side. He's very dangerous on the ball. They commit 2 players because they're that afraid of Palm Wonderful. If Palm Wonderful could take advantage of the fact that in overtime the Jets are committing 2 players when he has the ball and just pass it out to Prometheus, that could be a channel to success here for the Pandas. They've got all the time in the world as long as the Jets don't score first. There's Kraserlink out from the midfield, does not do much with it, just plays it around and back. Palm, though, will miss out. Kraser on the ball towards the near post, and all by himself, Kraserlink for the Jets wins it in Game 5.
Good control from Kraserlink here. Palm Wonderful getting beat on the challenge, and Prometheus just drifting towards that near post. He realizes far too late that the shot is on, floats right over top of him. It's heartbreak for the Pandas as the Jets will complete the reverse sweep and take the series 3-2.
Yeah, well done from the Jets. Nice showing, and we saw them lose 2 games in a row, and then they've just back-to-back 3 games in a row unanswered. That's the reverse sweep in a best-of-5 for the Jets, so all you can do is say hats off, and the Pandas, they tried. They've had a slow start in the league overall, and It looked like they had a hot start in the series, and then they just died down a little bit in Game 3 and Game 4, kept it close in Game 5, but in the end, they could not pull through, and that's the Jets winning it 3-2.
Third win, always the hardest one to get when you're trying to win a majority of games in a series. And the Pandas proving that again right there. They got 2 on the board. They got adjusted to really well by the Jets. And, you know, full credit to the Pandas. They adjusted right back to try and close out in Game 5. Just could not find a way to keep that lead stretched out far enough that the Jets could not pull it back in. And, you know, it'd be back to the drawing board for them. Still half of the season left, not out of the playoffs just yet, but still needing a lot of work as they move forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, again, thank you to those two, and hopefully we get to see the Pandas more, because it seems like they have been improving. They had a slow start, but every single week we see them, they do seem like they're getting better and better each week, and they took it to Game 5 this time, which is nothing to laugh at.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And it, you know, full credit to both teams. They played a really, really good series, and it was really fun to watch. Great start to the night. If you've loved one of the plays that you've seen tonight, make sure you've clipped it, tweet it to us at MLDoubles with the hashtag MLDPOTW to submit it for consideration for the MLD Play of the Week. Presented by Balls Guarana. Winner each week gets presented with a case of balls shipped right to their doorstep from our friends at Balls Guarana Energy Soda. And we will see you guys back here at the other side of the break. More Platinum League action coming up next as I check my league announcements real quick because I forgot what was up next. I've got Brisk
Wolves
on
the and
the mind.
Bears.
Wolves and the Bears. It'll be the Arctic against the Sun Division. We'll be back with more from Freestyle Friday here on the MLD Network right after this.
Woo-hoo!